Hello everyone, welcome to Geek Disorder's HTML5, CSS3, and JavaScript and jQuery series. This is Lavik. I'll be going through this series with you. Welcome to our web development tools video. This is video number 3. We're going to be going over what tools you'll be using when you start to develop web pages and deploy them to web servers. First, you have your text editors. A text editor lets you create basic files like HTML and CSS. A few different text editors are like Notepad, Notepad++. They're all free. Subtext editors like Notepad++ may have special features like auto-completion and syntax highlighting. Throughout the series, I'll be using Notepad++ in all my videos for this series. Then you have IDEs. An IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. An IDE provides features that go far beyond anything a text editor will offer, like generating code for you, managing folders and files for your projects both off and on the web server, drag drop for all kinds of HTML elements, and much more. Some of the most popular IDEs are like Adobe Dreamweaver and Microsoft Expression Web. Then you have FTP programs. A FTP program is a program that lets you transfer files to and from a web server using the file transfer protocol. Sometimes an FTP client may be included in a text editor or IDE. A few of the most popular FTP programs are FileZilla, QFTP, and Fetch. At the end of this series, I'll be showing you how to set up and use FileZilla. HTML and CSS validators. A validator checks the markup of your HTML and CSS files. If something is wrong, it will give you an error and try to help you find the problem. The most popular HTML validator can be found at that link, which is validator.w3.org. The most popular CSS3 validator can be found at jigsaw.w3.org/css-validator. More on validators. When using these validators, you can either give the validator the URL, the Uniform Resource Locator, or also known as a web address, or you can upload the file, like your HTML file, your CSS file, directly to the validator. Third but not least is you can copy all the code and paste it directly into the validator and run it that way. Most IDEs will have commands within the IDE itself to validate your code using the W3 validators and some of the others out there. Okay, this is Lavik with Geek Disorder. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I'll see y'all next time.